Alhamdulillah, Allah has given us tawfiq to spend some time in these few moments in the company of the greatest of people. After Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam, the ashab of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We were discussing recently how Sahaba would make fikr on their families, Sahabi making effort on his wife, Sahabiya, and they would make effort on their children. Then we started discussing those Sahaba who traveled far and wide to uplift Allah's deen and make deen available to humanity. Amongst those Sahaba was Hazrat Uqba bin Amir Juhani radiallahu anhu, that we just learned about. Just to mention a few more points about this great Sahabi radiallahu anhu, we were in the discussion showing what sacrifice he made through which Allah accepted him to be permanently in the company of Janabi Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Tawfiq comes in ajib ways. He made sacrifice for all his satis to benefit. Every one of them returned to their dwellings and areas. Allah accepted him. He then made hijrah to Madinah Munawwara and spent his life in the company of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a very knowledgeable sahabi. We were just learning how at times Allah's Nabi would call him, and at times he would approach the Nabi of Allah, the beloved of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to learn. Then Allah's Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught him these chapters of the Quran Kareem that are the most valuable of chapters of the Quran Kareem, because these are surahs mentioned in the Zabur, Torah, Injil as well. Allah give us tawfiq to make these surahs of the Quran Kareem. Every one of us know these surahs. We should make these surahs part and parcel of our life. We should learn the meanings of these chapters of the Quran Kareem. And we should understand these chapters. We should read them all the time. We should draw Allah Ta'ala's help through the Quran Kareem. And we should recite these chapters. Allah's Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam would read many, many beautiful du'as. We should learn those du'as. And when these chapters of the Quran Kareem were revealed, Allah's Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam emphasized these more than anything else. Among the incidents in the background of these verses of the Quran Kareem was the Jews and the forces of Batil tried everything to hinder the efforts of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Everything they tried. Even sending the Munafiqeen to trouble the Muslims from within, to attack the family members of Janabi Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And each time Allah Ta'ala's special help would come to his beloved Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and the Sahaba Kiram radiyallahu anhum. Then they had this individual who was Labid bin A'sam to actually do this black magic upon the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So what he did was, there was a youngster who was Jewish and he would make khidmah of Janabi Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Labid convinced him and bribed him to gain some blessed hair strands of Janabi Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam with Allah's Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's comb, some teeth from the comb Mubarak of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And from there he tied knots, he buried this in a certain well, and he did this magic upon the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. All of this would have an impact with the permission of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, because Allah Ta'ala made this world a place of means, and we have to draw Allah Ta'ala's help throughout our life in this world. One may feel, how could this have an impact on the beloved of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? But like this understanding of this would be like somebody has a fever or a flu, how that affects a human being, a person. Allah's Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, with Allah's permission, got ill. In the same way, this also affected him. And then, but what we have to remember is, this did not affect the Sharia nor the deen of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. It just affected the physical health of the Nabi of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, like what happens with sickness. Then Allah revealed these verses of the Quran Kareem, and Allah's Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam sees this dream where he sees the angels of Allah Ta'ala, and they are telling each other, and he is hearing the discussion, exactly what happened, what they did with the Mubarak hair, what they did with it, where is it. He sent Sahaba radiyallahu anhum to find it. The Mubarak hair of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was found. And these verses of the Quran Kareem was revealed again in Madinah Munawwara. And as Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would recite these chapters of the Quran Kareem, Allah Ta'ala would cause those knots, 11 knots, to be untied. And it was untied from the body of Janabi Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. كَأَنَّمَا نَشِطَ مِنْ عِقَالٍ, as though he was being untied from a rope. So what beautiful verses of the Qur'an Kareem that we should recite all the time to gain and acquire the special protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With yaqeen, we should read, Allah will definitely protect us. We should read, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Qul huwallahu ahad, Allahu samad, lam yalid, wa lam yulad, wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Qul a'udhu bi rabbil falaq. Allah is teaching us, Allah is telling us, say, O Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. O Nabi of Allah, tell humanity. And Allah is saying, say, O humanity, A'udhu bi rabbil falaq. I seek protection in the Lord of Daybreak. Min sharri ma khalaq. From all evil that is there, all evil that is created, Allah Ta'ala, we seek your protection. You save us from all that evil. Wa min sharri ghasiqin idha waqab. وَمِنْ شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ فِي الْعُقَدِ وَمِنْ شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَدٍ. From the evil of the dark nights, and when the moon envelops the entire humanity, what people do in the darkness of the night, Allah, you save us from the evil intent of people and the evil actions of people, what they perpetrate, what they plot, what they carry out in the darknesses of the night, under the light of the moon, Allah, you save us from that. And Allah, you save us from the evil of those who blow in the knots. And Allah, you save us from the evil of the jealous one when he carries out his deadly jealousy. Allah Ta'ala, save us. Then in the next chapter of the Quran Kareem, 114, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Qul a'udhu bi rabbin nas. Interesting here. We taking Allah's name repeatedly. I seek protection in Allah, the Lord of humanity. Malikin Nas, the King of humanity. Ilahin Nas, the deity, the worshipped one. Ilah, the one who is worshipped by humanity. The one who everyone is connected to. So we're taking Allah's name repeatedly. In the previous chapter, we took Allah Ta'ala's name once and from the harms of many, many things. Here we're taking Allah's name repeatedly. And from the harm of something which is very, very dangerous. That's why Allah Ta'ala's name is taken repeatedly. Because these harms cannot be seen with the physical eye. Min sharril waswasil khannas. From the evil of waswas. This is masdar. It comes for emphasis. Al khannas. He whispers professionally and then he retreats. When does he retreat? When one takes Allah's name, when one remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alladhi yuwaswisu fi sudurin nas, the one who whispers in the chests of humanity. Interestingly, the heart is not mentioned because no one has key to the heart of insan. Only Allah is in this heart. The heart has place for no other unless man allows entry of that thing, whether it be dunya, whether it be makhluq, whether it be things, whether it be shaitan. And which sort of shaitan? From the jinn kind and the mankind. The jinn kind is more influential. That's why he's mentioned first. And then mankind as well. Because they are those of man who assist jinn in whispering to humanity and harming people and causing discord and causing hatred and causing disunity and causing misunderstandings amongst families and people and humanity. We should hold on to these chapters. Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam emphasized to Hazrat Uqba radiallahu anhu that these are the best of chapters that anyone can be taught and the best of chapters to be recited. Even during Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's illness in this transitory world, Hazrat Aisha radiallahu anha would recite these chapters and blow it in the hands of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and make Allah's Nabi blow on his entire body, because there's shifa in these chapters. There's barakah in it, there's protection in it, there's solution in the chapters of the Quran-i-Kareem.